we'll get this chap across first and I'll give you a handover. Okay. We'll need to be careful moving him because he's got no sensation for his low spine further down, alright?
Alright, no worries. Okay.
Martin, you're doing absolutely fine, mate. Keep your eyes open for me just now, Martin. Okay.
Alright, okay.
Okay, so we've got Martin.
Yep.
Involved in a road traffic collision.
Okay.
He's a passenger, wasn't wearing a seatbelt. Vehicles rolled over at unknown speed. He was GCS 13 at the time.
Right.
Complaining of pain in his legs. He's got a massive boggy area at the back of his head. Left hand slightly avulsed, and he's got some lacerations in the back there as well.
Okay.
He has been drifting in and out of consciousness.
Gary, and then we'll let you know what's happening, okay?
Martin, I just need to shine a wee light in your eyes, okay? I'm just going to check your pupils, darling. You're doing really well. Okay, and the other side. Pupils are reacting, but his left's a little bit sluggish.
Nicola, this is Gary, 17-year-old, was in the arties, complaining of pain in his right upper arm and clavicle.
Okay, so we'll just get him over.
Have you got control, Rosemary?
I have.
Excellent. If you keep your hand at the top, just so we can have a look at his ear as well. That's super. All right, that's quite a nasty wound there. Okay, and you said it was boggy at the back
as well. I can feel it really boggy at the back.
All right.
One, two, three, slide.
Hi Gary, I'm Nicola, I'm one of the nurses, okay?
Right, I'm quite concerned about this head injury. We're going to need to get him off this board, we're going to need to get some x-rays and we're going to need to get him to CT so we can find out what's going on, okay?
Guys, can I get some help in here? I need to get this boy off this board. I'm just going, here's the doctor coming, okay Gary? You're doing well, okay?
Anton, can you get me some morphine drawn up, please? Thank you. Right, hi Gary, how are you?
Sore.
Sore. Okay, I'm just going to have a wee listen then, just some little breaths in and out for me. That's a really good man, brilliant. Alright, I just need to have a wee feel of your face here, alright? So tell me if it's sore. Alright, okay. This
Anton,
side.
Anton, could you get a porter, please?
Not so bad.
No. Thanks,
good.
Anton, if you
right.
get it for that.
Gary, look at my finger. Follow my finger. Well done. Excellent, okay.
All the monitors disconnected, we're good to go.
Where's Louise?
2, 3, roll.
Right, okay, Martin, I'm going to feel down your spine, okay? Tell me if it feels sore anywhere. You feel me touch you? Is it sore? Can you feel me touch you?
No.
Okay, all right, Martin. We're going to need to do a few more tests.
What does that mean to do that?
We don't know what it means at the moment. What we need to do is we need to do some x-rays and we need to get a scan, okay? Once we've done that, we'll have a lot more information.
Hi, are your parents in?
Yeah. Mum, it's police.
Are you Louise's mum?
Yes. What's happened to her? Is she okay?
Can I take a little seat just now, please? Can I sit down as well?
Yeah. Thank you. Has something happened to her? Is she okay?
Earlier on this evening, there was a road accident.
Was Louise in it?
Louise was in the back of the car. The road accident was quite a severe road accident. The car rolled over. I'm sorry to say that she's dead.
No, it can't be her. It can't be her. She was just here. You must have brought the wrong person.
No, I'm sorry, but we are sure that it is Louise.
No. No, it can't be her. She was just here with us. It can't be her.
We need two people to identify Louise's body.
No, she can't. It's not her. We must have got the wrong person.
I need you to come to the mortuary to identify Louise's body.
Well, Mrs. Hunter, we've got your son's images back now. What we've got here is we've got a picture of his spine, okay? Normally we would expect a nice cube shape like this. Unfortunately, this one has a couple of breaks in it and it's pushed backwards. It's pressing on his spine, okay? This is why he cannot feel his legs at the moment. What that might mean is that he may not walk again, all right?